Big day today, DALL-E 3, the third version of the legendary text-to-image AI, is coming. No, we can't try this yet, there is no product or paper yet, only the initial announcement. Now, it seems that it does three things better than all the other techniques out there. So, what does it do well? Well, first, it listens. Now, I hear you asking, Doctor, what do you mean by that? Well, with other techniques, important parts of our prompts often get lost. However, not here. When we enter a detailed prompt, it really tries to take all of it into consideration. If I write the prompt, I want to get that mustache to be noteworthy, and this one, I would say, is. And some of these prompts can get bloody long, and I just kept looking and looking, but I think I might see everything that was requested here. Even for things that are really difficult to paint or, sometimes, even imagine. Try to imagine a whirlwind of porcelain fragments, harmonious fluid forms in a dreamlike atmosphere, and so on. Excellent. Two, I am wondering, can this really compete? I mean, Midjourney and Stable Diffusion have become so incredibly good, I can imagine that even DALL-E 3 might have a hard time competing. Now, we have a little indication here. Oh yes, the legendary prompt from DALL-E 2, an expressive oil painting of a basketball player dunking depicted as an explosion of a nebula. And now, look, this is what it looks like with version 3. More detail, more definition, more life. I find it a great deal better. Great job, little AI. And three, now hold on to your papers, fellow scholars, for better integration with ChatGPT. You see, we don't even need to write the prompts directly, we can even ask it to make up a new character. Let's call him Larry the Hedgehog. And we get Larry. Larry is amazing. So let's get some more images, and now you immediately see that getting several images created about the same character is not a trivial matter at all. We've looked at a bunch of papers that tried to pull that off, and now it is here. But every hedgehog needs a house, so it can imagine that too. That is a beautiful house, and look at that. Text. Fantastic. I really want that, because we have been promised proper text support in text-to-image, and, at least for me, it never quite worked out without significant cherry-picking. I hope this is gonna be better here. And then, finally, we can ask for stickers of the amazing Larry and even a bedtime story with him. I have a 7-year-old daughter, and just thinking about the amount of fun we are going to have with this gives me goosebumps. Love it. Thank you so much. Now, one more thing. There is no paper. Mm-mm. Here, I can only comment on what I see in the announcement, and the cases that we see here are usually not the average, but the best case scenarios. However, we will be able to try this and find out soon, no doubt. What a time to be alive! I was also happy to see that it will not create an image in the style of a living artist. And when I watched their video, what do I see? Proper, and I mean proper, scholarly representation. That is what I see. Well done, fellow scholars. If you're looking for inexpensive cloud GPUs for AI, Lambda now offers the best prices in the world for GPU cloud compute. No commitments or negotiation required. Just sign up and launch an instance. And hold on to your papers, because with the Lambda GPU Cloud, you can now get on-demand H100 instances for just $199 per hour. Yes, $199. And they are one of the first cloud providers to offer publicly available on-demand H100 access. Did I mention they also offer persistent storage? So, join researchers at organizations like Apple, MIT, and Caltech in using Lambda Cloud instances, workstations, or servers. Make sure to go to lambdalabs.com/papers to sign up for one of their amazing GPU instances today.